Good morning class. So today we are going to do chapter number 4, adjective. Okay, first of all, as usual, I am writing the present date here. Today is May 11 and this video you will see tomorrow on 12 May. Alright, so in English period you have to complete the task which I am going to underline or going to teach you. Alright, so adjective, as we know, adjective is quality showing word. Quality showing word, or we can say describing word. All right. So we know that an adjective describes a noun or a pronoun. Noun or pronoun. This you will write. Okay. Now let's learn its various kinds. Now we will see its various. Okay, so adjectives of quality, they describe the size, color or shape of a noun. So first one is adjective of quality. So from the word only it is described, it is given that quality is what. So they describe the size, color or shape of a noun. They answer the question, what kind. Okay. For example, the old man walked down the dirty street. In this sentence, old and dirty are adjectives of quality. Understood? Again, they describe the size. Okay. Size like circle, oval, okay, rectangular, okay, or we can say big or small. Circle and rectangular, they are shape. All right. So size, big or small. Okay, color red, green, blue, shape oval, circle, rectangular, that's all are shape. Okay, so for example, again describing, they describe the size, color or shape of a noun. They answer the question, what kind. An example I have given here, the old man walked down the dirty street. So in this sentence, old and dirty, these are adjectives. Now number two, adjectives of quantity. They describe the quantity of uncountable nouns. They answer the question, how much. Understood? How much. They answer the question, how much. So much rice was wasted on the way to the store house. So in this sentence, much is rice. Okay, I mean much is adjective of quantity. Okay, how much, adjective of quantity. Uncountable nouns, this we use to quantify, to describe an uncountable noun. Understood? Now next, adjectives of number. So it is given from the word only, number. They describe the number of countable nouns. They answer to how many. How many? Countable. How much? Uncountable. How many? Countable. How much? Uncountable. Okay, this you have to keep in your mind. For example, there were many children in the park. Okay, so adjectives of numbers. Okay, or you can write here in place of many, you can write here there were 7. Okay, let's write it in numbers. There are 7 children in the park. There are 7 children in the park. Now number 4th, demonstrative adjective. So it is given from the word only, demonstrate. These adjectives are used to point out specific nouns. This, that, these and those are demonstrative adjective. But when they will be demonstrative adjective? When? Just after these words, like this, that, these, those, there should be a noun. Okay. So for example, this is given, these boys, only these boys. Okay, these boys are very naughty. In this sentence, these is demonstrative adjective and naughty is adjective of quality. Okay, adjective of quality. Now these are, these word is demonstrative adjective. Now number 5, possessive adjective. So again it is given from the word only, possessive. These adjectives show ownership of nouns. Okay, they come before noun. My, your, his, her, its, our, their are possessive adjectives. The dog wagged its tail. So in this sentence, its is possessive adjective. Or I'm writing one more example here. This is my pen. In this sentence, the words my is possessive adjective. Okay, this is my pen. Now, sixth number, interrogative adjective. These adjectives are used only in the form of questions and are always accompanied by a noun. What, whose, where, why, how, and which are used as interrogative adjectives. So, whose books are these? Okay, this is what in this sentence. Whose is what? This is interrogative adjective. Understood? Now, number 7, proper adjective. These adjectives are derived from proper noun and they often describe the origin of source of noun. Proper adjectives are more or less adjectives of quality. So, the Egyptian culture. In this sentence, Egyptian is what? This is proper adjective. This is proper adjective. Flourish along the Nile River. Understood? Now, distributive adjective. These adjectives are usually used to refer to the number of a group as individuals. For example, each, every, either, neither, all are distributive adjective. Neither candidate was found suitable for the job. None of them means there was no candidate who was found suitable for the job. It means so. All right. Emphasizing adjective. These adjectives are used to emphasize or show strong feelings. How? I was horrified to see the sheer wastage of food. So, in this sentence, sheer is what? This is emphasizing adjective. So, this is example of emphasizing adjective. I was horrified to see the sheer wastage of food at the banquet hall. Understood? Now, after doing this, that what is it? Next point is formation of adjective. What is the formation? Some adjectives are derived by the means here. What we are doing? We are just forming adjectives from some noun, from some words. And from some adjectives also. So, some adjectives are derived by adding suffixes to noun, verbs and adjectives. Wood is a noun. We have form a wooden chair. So, wooden will be what adjective? Affection. It's a noun. Affectionate. So, affectionate is what? It is an adjective. Okay, now verb. From verb, what we can do? Talk. Talk is verb. She is very talkative. So, talkative is what? Adjective. Charm. Verb, charming. He is very charming. So, in this sentence, charming is what? Adjective. Understood? So, now next we can see here adjectives of. This is adjectives. From the adjective only we are forming another adjective. And how we are doing that? You can see black is what? Black is adjective. Blackish. We have formed here the another adjective by using black. Now, small, smallish. So, these are what we are doing. We are just forming another adjective from the adjective only. Now, we use common suffixes to form adjectives. So, this you will keep in your book only. Okay. I am just reading it, but these parts you will not write in your notebook. Okay. We use common suffixes to form adjective. In certain cases, when a suffix is added to an adjective, we may need to alter the spelling too. How it will be? Like we are using these suffixes. Okay, you can see these are the suffixes. Possible, plausible, unthinkable, terrible. Okay, these are all examples of adjective. Careless, homeless, motionless, using less we are forming here adjective full. By using suffix full we are making here adjective graceful, hopeful, blissful, harmful. Okay, using suffix y, cloudy, lazy, skinny, easy. Okay, ish, ish, darkish, reddish, bookish. Okay, so here by using this we are forming here adjective ed, bored, boned, concealed. Okay, so these are what, these are adjectives. L, natural, nature, natural, nation, national, music, musical. Okay, so ik, ic, ik we are forming here classic, artistic, photogenic, heroic. Ive, ive, active. Okay, from act, active. Attract, attractive. Progress, progressive. Expressive. Okay, express, expressive. So in the same way, the thing you can see here, by putting some suffixes we can form adjectives. Okay, these you will not write in your notebook, they these things we will keep in our book only. Now very important thing, degrees of adjective, this we should know. Okay, so there are mainly 3 degrees of comparison. Adjectives we use to compare. Okay, for comparison also we use adjectives. So adjectives have 3 degrees of comparison: positive, comparative and superlative. You can see when there will be no comparison, no comparison, we will use positive degree. When there will be comparison between two, then we will use comparative degree. When there will be comparison between many, among all, okay, or many, then we will use superlative degree. Okay, so now let's start it. This you have to do in your notebook. Okay, positive degree, no comparison is made in the positive degree. He is tall. Simple example, he is tall. So comparative degree, when there will be comparison between two nouns. A comparison is made between two nouns in the comparative form. We use then. Okay, keep this thing in your mind. To make the comparison, and we mostly add er at the end of the adjective to form its comparative degree. For example, same thing. He is a tall man. That's okay that he is a tall man. Now here we are doing a comparison of this person with someone else. So we have written here, he is taller than his cousin. So here we are doing comparison of him with his cousin. So taller. Next, superlative degree. A comparison is made between more than two nouns in the superlative degree. So comparison between more than two. The word though precedes the adjective in the superlative form. We mostly add est at the end of the adjective to form its superlative degree. Yes, very important thing, that the word though precedes the adjective in the superlative degree or superlative form. Example is given, he is the tallest of all his cousins. So in this sentence, tallest is superlative degree of an adjective. Here, taller, comparative degree of an adjective. Tall, positive degree of an adjective. Okay, you can see here, this is very important topic, degrees of comparison. Okay. Now important point, negative comparison using not often use positive degree of adjective. He is not as cheerful as his sister. Okay, in this case we will use positive degree in place of we are doing comparison between two. Okay, but this is a negative sentence, so in this kind of sentence we will use positive degree instead of comparative degree. Second, when making a comparison at the same level, we use the positive degree of comparison. How? This book is as fascinating as the previous one. So what we are doing here, we are doing comparison at the same level. Okay, third, When one noun is singled out in a group, we use the superlative degree of comparison. Very important. This is the best story in the entire book. Now what we are doing? We are just making one thing, and this is the best thing we can say. So it is what we are doing. We use the superlative. We are using the superlative degree of comparison. Fourth, usually adjectives with more than two syllables use more and most to form their comparative and superlative degree. For example, intelligent. So here we can say there are more than two syllable. Okay, there are more than two syllables, so we are using more and most. What is syllable? Like if we speak this word in, okay, I will tell you how. So in one syllable, tell, entirely, two syllable, gent, third syllable. This is syllable first, two and three. So here are basically three syllables. Can you see when we speak these words, how many times our tongue is folding? That is depending on syllables. Intelligent. Okay, intelligent, three syllables we can see here. So in this sentence we will use more and most. Intelligent, more intelligent, most intelligent. Expensive, more expensive, most expensive. Now next point, some adjectives do not take the regular form of comparison. These adjectives are called irregular. This is also very important. These are called irregular adjectives, and examples are good, better, best, bad, worse, worse, far, further, furthest. These are the examples of irregular adjectives. Okay, much more, most, many more, most, that also you can write here. Okay, much more, most, same as many more, most. Okay, so these are what, these are examples of degrees of comparison in case of adjectives. Okay, so this we have seen here. I think syllables, what is syllable, that you have understood. Okay, so here this is very important. We should understand the order of adjectives, that which adjective will come at which place. Okay, adjective in a sentence are usually arranged in a specific order. There is a specific order in which we have to arrange the adjective. Number one, quantity or number. If there will be any quantity or number, then that will come first. Then second number will be quality or opinion. Third, size. Fourth, age. Fifth, shape. Sixth, color. Seventh, origin. Eighth, purpose. Okay, okay, now let's see the example here. So determiner we are using here, we can say quantity or number. A, the, and n, quantity or number, three. Okay, these are example. This table in the same way you will write in your notebook. Okay, so quantity or number, three. Quality or opinion, this is actually, this is example 1, this is example 2, this is example 3, and this is 4. You can see a beautiful big old red Italian sports car. The three gorgeous oval white plates. An amazing king-sized red and white leather sofa. Two good-looking tall young Russian men. So these are basically 4 examples we can see. Okay, and the words which have come here, how we have arranged these all adjectives, how we have arranged, that is given. Okay, first determiner has come, then quantity or quantity or number, three or two, then quality, beautiful here, beautiful, gorgeous, amazing, amazing, good looking, then size, big, king size, tall, age, old, young, shape, oval. Okay, color, red, white, red and white, origin, Italian and Russian, purpose and material, sports, leather, noun, purpose or material, we have written here purpose, sports, material, leather, noun, car, plate, sofa, men. Okay, Now we have formed four sentences here. Okay, this is the way, this is how you will do it. Okay, and noun will come at last till here. So determiner is not at all there, no problem. Okay, but first of all, if there will be any determiner, then first, this is how we form a sentence. Okay, so that is why it is given. Understood? In the same way, you will write it in your notebook. These exercises I have given you in your homework. Okay, weekly homework. So do it yourself. These are your weekly homework. Okay. Okay, till here. Now, till here, we have completed today our grammar topic. I mean, grammar topics which are coming in UT1. Okay. So, Unit 1, Section ABC in Literature, plus 4 chapters, Chapter 1, 2, 3 and 4 of Grammar. Alright, these are coming in your UT 1. Okay, and in Writing Section, I'll just give the syllabus to your class teacher, and your class teacher will, upload it on our YouTube channel, so you can see from there. Okay, complete this chapter as soon as possible. Okay, thank you so much for watching.